As Passover approaches, I've been thinking a lot about two reasons why I'm religious instead of just spiritual. The first is because being religious locates me in community. It invites me and it even obligates me into relationship, into mutual connection with other people, folks who are like me and folks who are unlike me. Along with 200 other people, I just returned from Reckoning Together, a Reconstructionist pilgrimage to civil rights sites in the South. And I had the great blessing of hearing Reverend Dr. Senator Raphael Warnock speak at Sunday services at Ebenezer Baptist Church. He talked to us about the impoverishment of being an isolated individual and the richness that can come from living life in community. Judaism is, at its core, a religion of collectivity and community. And another reason I am religious is because being religious helps me move beyond my own individual preoccupations, my own limited view of the world. Left to my own devices, I might not want to think about the big questions and even more the big asks of a holiday like Passover. I might not want to take on what is the meaning of freedom and how do I tell the story? How do I act in the world as if I myself were liberated from slavery? I might be distracted by other things going on in the world or in my life. The questions might feel too hard. I might just get caught up in cleaning or cooking for Seder. But the religious approach gives me a framework and even pushes me to think about these themes, these questions, these obligations. And I'm grateful. I'm feeling the intersection of these two reasons powerfully this year. On our recent pilgrimage to civil rights sites, we visited Ebenezer Baptist Church and Dr. Martin Luther King's grave. In Selma, we heard from an activist who marched across the Edmund Pettus Bridge on Bloody Sunday and retraced the marcher's steps. In Montgomery, we went to the Rosa Parks Museum and the Equal Justice Initiative's Legacy Museum, from enslavement to mass incarceration, as well as the National Memorial for Peace and Justice, the lynching monument. Much of the information in the EJI Museum was not new to me, but the presentation and framing of it was so powerful and so painful, it was staggering. I strongly urge every American to visit. I haven't yet figured out how to integrate what I'm thinking and feeling about this encounter with the horrors of 400 years of chattel slavery and the profoundly imperfect emancipation and the lasting implications of structural racism into this year's celebration of Passover, the holiday of liberation and freedom that is so foundational to Jewish self-understanding. I haven't yet figured out how to engage in the metaphorical performance of the Seder while responsibly integrating in information and insights and actions arising out of this pilgrimage in a way that respects the experiences of Black people and Black Jews without appropriating or minimizing their stories, their history. It took me a while to remember that I don't have to figure it out on my own. Being a religious Jew means that actually we are discouraged from trying to do it all on our own. It's together we ask questions and ponder answers and then ask more questions. We piece and patch responses and actions together. We support each other and we call each other in when we miss the mark. Hopefully we find beauty in what we have inherited and we create relevance for our lives. We eat a lot of really good food and sing songs. We promise to do it again next year and look forward to seeing how we will be the same next year and how we will be changed and what we will have done to change the world around us. So this year, at our Seder, we will ask these very questions, knowing that the answers will be provisional, gaining strength from our relationships and from the conversations themselves. As Dr. Chanda Prescott Weinstein writes in her Evolve essay, "What to the Black Jew is Passover?" You may find yourself feeling like you do not know how to ask. That is a fine place to begin the story. May your Seder be delicious and full of equally nourishing conversation and connection. May you know liberation, and may you be strengthened in your efforts to help others know the same. May you have a sweet and meaningful Passover. Chag Sameach.